We can make this happen. Now or never.
You know Ricardo Chavira as our South Texas pride, and now with the iconic Selena legacy, captured in the extended series with Chavira playing the patriarch, Abraham Quintanilla.
It's been a week now since Selena came out, and you know, all my friends and family, that's what we did this weekend. We binge watched.
A lot, that's what I've been hearing. A lot of people, I've been getting a lot of really nice text messages from family and friends here in town. The mayor tweeted something about, you know, he was going to binge watch. It's been really nice. You know, Selena and I were born the same year, 4 months apart. So I'm growing up in San Antonio and, you know, I'd read in the paper, San Antonio Express News or the San Antonio Light even, that, you know, that she had a concert in Rosedale Park. And there she was accepting an award at the Tejano Music Awards that were held at the Convention Center in San Antonio.
This series showing more of what she meant to her family, unlike the 1997 biopic with Jennifer Lopez.
I heard you didn't watch Selena, the movie, is that right?
No, I've yet to watch it. I'm actually probably going to watch it this coming week with my daughter. I grew up around it. So it's like, you grow up around it, you're like, I don't need to see that movie. I know it. You know, I know that story already. I've lived it. You know, it's been a part of my life, an aspect of my life. And then when I started going down the road of auditioning for this and knowing that I was getting close and possibly going to play the role, I was like, you know, I don't want to do that to myself. I think that would be doing myself a disservice. I don't want that to inform any decisions that I'm going to make as an actor on how I'm going to approach this role. And I also knew that Abraham is a Mexican-American man, father of a certain age and a certain generation, that is exactly my father and exactly many of my tios, you know?
One thing he can relate to with the Quintanilla family, growing up Mexican-American, yet knowing little Spanish.
And you get it from both sides. Like, you know, the white side, it's like, you know, you're too ethnic. And then the Mexican side, you're not Mexican enough, you know? So, and those are things that I've had to deal with my whole life as well. Yeah.
Yes.
And it's like, you know, at our core, we are Mexican. We're Mexican-American.
Yes. So, yeah, I I'm assuming that helped you with the understanding for this role here with Abraham and the family, and seeing Selena say, well, Dad, I don't know Spanish. And that really connected with me. So I would imagine that connected with you, too.
The same thing. Yeah, very much so. A lot of the filming that we did went with the younger versions of the children, you know, those scenes and those weeks of shooting were some of my absolute favorite weeks of shooting. Because we really kind of bonded as a family, and not to take anything away from Christian or Noemi or Gabrielle, because I love working with all three of them as well. But just the bonding that Sadie and I had with those kids, all of those scenes, all the different stuff, it really kind of gelled us as this ensemble family that is representative of the Quintanillas.
You started playing the guitar, correct, for this role?
Yeah.
How's that going?
yeah, it's going. It is very much a work in progress.
I'm so glad that you get to be part of sharing this to a new generation. One of our viewers wanted me to ask you that.
I think it's great. I mean, you know, my daughter is 12 years old, you know, and when she was in elementary school, they had to do a project on somebody famous, and she chose Selena, and she wrote a paper, and she dressed up like her as best she could, and so, you know, and she watched the movie, and now she's, you know, I thought we were going to watch the series together, and apparently she's already binge-watched it and seen the whole thing, so.
For many who watched, we are left wondering, when is part two coming out?
I wouldn't think that it's going to take too long, but I can't give you any kind of definitive answer on that.
All right, we'll wait. We'll see.
Which means I do know, I'm just not telling. So.
I'm like, come on, Ricardo. Okay, we can't get it out of you.
Nope, he was not going to share that, but he knows.
Not spilling the beans.
I was reading, I don't know, I'm thinking maybe April. That's my guess. Maybe April around Selena Day, but so many things I didn't get to include. He mentioned author Shay Serrano, who's from San Antonio as well, and he loved his review because he says this is a supplement to the movie. A lot of people are comparing it, right?
You can't compare it.
It's 12 hours, guys. So this is the deeper story, the perspective from the family and what they went through. And shout out to Richard Velez because he let Ricardo Ricardo use his studio because he's having internet issues. But speaking of San Antonio, I didn't get to include some places that he loves to go to. Whataburger, of course, but shout out to Las Palapas.
Really?
Yes.
Nice.
Yes. And so he's always missing that when he's out and about.